Sorry, I'm a bit, I was a bit late, but when I came here, I heard Swami Vivekananda. And I remembered that in India, during that time, when Vivekananda was in India, on the so in India, during 19th century, 20th century, we had some very good English scholars. And can you just recall whose English you would like to listen or you would like to read? Tell me. Just two persons, two great scholars, two great thinkers who could speak English very well or who could write English very well. Just give me two names.
I know one of them.
Two names. If you read English, you would just rejoice that it was Swami Vivekananda and Mahatma Gandhi. These were two talented persons who could speak English very well and who could write English very well. Though when we talk of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Radhakrishnan, they were scholars, no doubt. But when you read them, then you would see their English is very, very complicated. Oh, very long sentences like that. But when you read Mahatma Gandhi and Vivekananda, small sentences and perfect sentences. So I would just advise you, because you come here to learn spoken English, some better English, so you should try to read Vivekananda and Mahatma Gandhi. And you will really see the difference between these two authors and the greatest scholars like Jawaharlal Nehru, Radhakrishnan, and others. So that is the beauty of the language. So any language, whether it is Hindi, English, whatever we say, it should have some content, it should have some weight. Even if we speak two sentences, three sentences, two words, three words, they should carry some weight. You could recall when Abraham Lincoln just said that, what is democracy? Democracy is government by the people, for the people. Nobody heard it. Nobody heard him. Nobody was very serious. Okay, they just ignored him. But when these words came in the press, then people realized what wonderful speech it was. So still till today, we remember Abraham Lincoln and his definition of democracy. Because the language only, he had very few words, and he finished his speech within 10 minutes, hardly 10 minutes. But all the speech had some content in that. So please remember one thing. You can learn very good English. You can shout like any big leader, but that is not very important. Whatever you say, they should carry some meaning. Whatever I say, they should carry some meaning. When Vivekananda spoke, he carried some meaning. That is why people were influenced by him. You even hear Acharya Rajneesh. His words carry some meaning. So, please learn one thing, that your spoken aspect or written English, there should have some meaning hidden in that. Only after that, people would be able to praise you or appreciate you. Simply speaking, narrating, shouting, that won't serve. Even if you want to become some, join some corporate world or like that, or even the government. Even in the government, if you want to become a good officer or in corporate world. So, be smart. Smart means whatever you say should be a smarter aspect, a smart thing. And it should convey something to others. That is more important. In conversation, in English or in Hindi or in any language, we should be able to convey what we think of it. Sometimes we think something else and we convey something. So there is always some gap between your conception and convenience. So what you were talking about good governance, good governance means when outcome is more important, not output. In computer, you give input and then output would be there. Okay, no problem. But in governance, input is there, output is there, but output is not as important as the outcome. For example, if Prime Minister has launched one scheme, Swachh Bharat scheme, everybody is carrying some boom sticker like that and having selfies and other things. That is not important. That is outcome. The output. Outcome is when you see India clean. That is the outcome. Because that was the purpose. So what is our purpose? What is our objective? That should be delivered. That should be there. That should appear. So even if you join the private sector, so always emphasize on the outcome. Because in private sector, outcome is more important. In government, you can just be fool people, no problem. But in private sector, because they want outcome, they want the result. Result is more important. Please take it from me or just believe it that whenever and wherever you serve, always emphasize on the outcome, the delivery. That is more important. So you try to develop your personality like that, where you have faith in outcome, not in output, or in just narrating and speaking and shouting. That is not important. In leadership, it can be important. Okay, a leader can befool you and take your votes. That's all. And that is their objective, that is their purpose. But in private sector, they want the result, the outcome. So please always just keep it in your mind that wherever you serve, because you are just children of you. I have seen full of my life and I just crossed 70. So I know if we just waste our time, then we won't be able to serve the country. Even whether if you are in private sector and government sector, the real purpose is to serve the people or even to serve the company which you are serving. Serving the company may also have some effect on the people. That may leave some impact on the people. Some good impact, some bad impact. So try to distinguish between these two things. You are serving for the profit of the company, no doubt. Good. But with that objective, you should also have some objective for the welfare, for the good of the people. So, with these two objectives, okay, objective of the company, that they should have some good result, they should have some more profit, and on the simultaneously, you should also believe that whatever work you are doing in the company, that should also leave some good impact on the people or on the customers, because customer welfare, customer's well-being is also important in the long term. If your product leaves bad impact on the customer, then your company, no doubt, in the first year, second year, you will have some profit. But what afterwards? Then you may lose it. So for long term, you should believe that your effort should leave good impact on the people. That is very important. So output is there, outcome should be very important. Then good impact on the stakeholders. Stakeholders can be customers, stakeholders can be your employees and your bosses. They are all stakeholders. So they should also have satisfaction with your work. So anyway, we can go on talking, but whatever I did, I just took some hint from your speeches and like that. And one thing more, when you were speaking here, you just trying to shorten the speeches of some article or like that. You should also try to understand the content of that. For example, when you spoke of Raghuram Raja, so you should try to understand what IAS has written, what was the meaning behind it, why government is forcing him to leave the job, why. It is not that he has exposed the bad loans or the assets which were not to return like that. No. The main thing is, it is about the difference between the thinking of Rajan and the thinking of the government. When government in liberalization, because now we have completed 25 years of liberalization. 25 years. So, in liberalization, we have to serve the purpose of the private sector, that is the corporate world. When the corporate world supports the government, then the corporate world also needs something in the return. They also want some support from the government. And the best support is to reduce the rate of interest. But Rajan was of the view that if I reduce the rate of interest, then there will be inflation. Because when more money is in the market, then the prices will go up. How we contain prices, you know? You just withdraw money from the market, then the prices will fall down. And if you throw money in the market, then prices will soar very high. Because throughout the world, there was recession and prices were going very high. So Rajan thought that India should sustain it. And for that, he did not reduce the interest rate. So that was the clash between, okay, these clashes continue, but we should not be very much involved in that. We should try to understand the content of